22, Maggie Holt.
It's days like this one last week that are the hardest for Dorothy Holt, coaching against her youngest daughter, Maggie, a freshman who plays at NYA.
It's hard. I miss a lot. And we have that discussion after every season, like, do you guys, you know, how's it feel? Does it bother you?
Maggie's sister, Ellie, a junior at Greely, won't play her mother until the last game of the regular season.
It's kind of, I guess, the way our life was meant to be. Kind of meant to be crazy, meant to be competitive.
Ellie's competitive fire got the best of her after the first time she played her mom's team when she was a freshman and lost convincingly.
She was not happy. She stormed in, threw her backpack on the bench in the mudroom, went upstairs, did not come down for a good hour. My husband handled that. I cooked dinner.
That competitiveness got a test when the sisters played against each other earlier this year, but they tried to keep it loose.
The start of the game, we were on the circle with each other, and we were like joking with each other, but it was fun.
Becca Kelker is Ellie's coach and used to be her mom's assistant coach, and sees a silver lining in this family triangle.
I think she would prefer to coach against them than coach them. I almost think it's easier that way to give a little bit of separation between that relationship as mom and coach.
The spring season is a hectic one in the Holt household, but the underlying competitor in each Holt means they're all chasing the same goal, a state championship.
For them to go to a lacrosse state final, each of them would be a dream come true for each of them. Now, if it's against me, I will lose a lot of sleep. That's all I can say. I don't know. And my poor husband and my son. Yeah.